rebound and the stuff both. Wow.
Yep, he stayed with it all the way and got his reward at the end.
So it's Boston now. Garnett kicks to Pierce. Pass to Perkins. Shot clock at 5. Nobody near Allen. No good from outside.
You know what, though? Sometimes you can be too open. I think it may have surprised him, and that's why he missed.
Williams passes to O'Neal. To the paint. Morning. Shakes off the strong D and gets to the bucket for 2.
You love it when a big man has those soft hands. Rarely any problem converting that close to the rim.
It's Pierce on the wing. Back to Rondo. Perkins dishes to Allen. He feeds it to Pierce. Rondo kicks to Pierce. Over in the corner, Allen buries it from three-point range. Allen's got his first 3 points of the game.
They really can't allow him too many open looks like that. I mean, that's just inviting trouble.
Reed with it. He's picked up by Rondo. From 11 feet away. And, yep, finally dropped after rolling around the rim.
And really, that's what you want every time down the floor. A simple, high-percentage shot.
And about 2 minutes played here in the first quarter. Garnett the pass to Perkins. It's Pierce with the drive. The dish to Allen. Kicks it to Perkins. The Celtics need to get a shot off. Wade with the block. And there's the shot clock violation. Couldn't get the shot off in time. If you're just tuning in, we played about 2.5 minutes here in the first. Misses in close.
Terrific job that time defending at the rim. I mean, it's not an easy task stopping that fella when he's headed to the bucket like that. Good job.
I tell you what, guys, it's going to be a tough day on this defense if he's got the A game rolling tonight.
Passes it to O'Neal. Oh, and that one, no question, powered it down.
Reverse that one home. Now that was nice. Real nice.
The agility on display.
Yeah, you love that body control.
How about the power and grace on that finish?
Now here's Rondo. To the wing right side. Perkins inside. Guarded by O'Neal. Shot clock at 3. Allen for 3. No good. Excellent D from Wade. It's 2-on-1. Outside Williams releases. They get the rebound. And so he draws the foul on the shot. A trip to the line to shoot 2.
I mean, even from over here, you can see that one pretty clearly.
No question about it, Greg. I mean, a ton of contact and a good call by the official.
And so Walker nails both of them. And first quarter, we're about 3.5 minutes in. Rondo kicks to Perkins. Pass to Pierce. And a check with the rebound. Miami leading by 5. Wade dishes to Morning. Back to Wade. Morning with the screen. Wade kicks to Morning, and he comes off the screen and slams it through.
Ooh, that's as forceful a finish as you're ever going to see out of this guy.
Well, gee, it adds now to their lead in spectacular fashion.
And, you know, that lead's only going to grow if they're not prepared to defend a little more staunchly than that.
So it's the Celtics now. After the Heat pick up 2, Rondo kicks to Allen. Pierce with a wide-open look. Gets it to go from beyond the arc. Pierce has got himself on the board with 3 there. Here's Miami now. They lead by 4. Williams passes to O'Neal. Good, and it's Williams who picks up the assist.
They've worked hard and created great chances for themselves in this opening quarter.
And if they match that effort at the defensive end, watch out.
Now here's Rondo looking for his first basket still in this one. Perkins dishes to Pierce. 6 on the shot clock. Over in the corner, Allen. And again, Boston with the triple.
How about the passing? They are moving the ball without any thought, without any individual agenda.
Yeah, and it's really fun to see that kind of unselfishness. Really hard not to appreciate all the assists they've racked up.
Rondo kicks to Perkins, and he uses both hands to jam it in.
You know, he's not your typical NBA center in terms of height, guys, but he plays as big as any of them, thanks to his incredible bounceability.
Now here's Williams. The pass to Morning. And a foul on the shot. He'll go to the stripe for two. And let's take a moment here to get your guys' take on scoring so far for the Heat.
You know, guys, we've really seen them do a lot of damage in the paint so far.
And the other thing, though, is their execution in terms of their ball movement has been flawless. Sets up a lot of easy scoring opportunities.
Celtics making a switch here. Poe is checked in. Rondo with a clean look. Here's Allen. The kick out to Pierce. Outside Rondo. Allen against Wade. Back to Rondo. It's Pierce on the wing. And no good. Had a chance to take the lead. The Heat with the lead. Inside. It's deflected. Rondo with the steal. Wade against Allen. He dishes it to Rondo. He kicks to Perkins. Allen for three, and that one's good. Allen's got 11 points.
A lot of space right there to get that shot off.
Not a very good job of the defender getting over the top of that screen in that particular play.
And Miami calls their first timeout of the game.
And did not seem happy about how things are going on right now, and maybe wants to make some changes.
I agree. I mean, just was not comfortable with the way things were set up at that particular time, and in that case, I think it's the right thing to do.
Giannis Haslov, he's checked in for Miami. Payton comes in for Jason Williams. And then for Boston, Davis comes in for Kendrick Perkins. And it's Cassell in for Rajon Rondo. Payton passes to Haslam. Haslam a screen. And Walker kicks to Payton. Wade against Allen. Wade can't hit. The Celtics with the lead. Outside Pierce. Dishes to Poe. Back to Pierce. Takes a big high bounce and goes in. And now it's a 3-point Celtic lead.
How about the leaner? Only the guys with the sweetest of strokes can pull that off in traffic.
Payton drives in. That's good.
How about the way he's able to angle his body to shield the big fella off and still get the finish?
You've got to be clever with your sleight of hand when you get inside and try to finish against the bigger guys. And he made it look easy that time.
Allen kicks to Davis. The feed to Poe. Pierce for three. Pierce with another miss. Miami with the ball. They trail by one. And Walker gets it to go on the assist by Payton.
And that's the kind of lead pass we've come to expect from him.
Here's Cassell. Still getting warmed up offensively. No buckets yet in the game for him. Feeds to Pierce. Allen outside. Pass to Cassell. Here's Davis. Miami grabs the miss. Walker with it. It's Wade in the corner. He feeds it to Mourning from 11 feet away. The shot no good. Great D that time from Davis.
Tell you what, they haven't wasted any time getting into the swing of things on the boards.
And even this early, that's a good omen for the rest of the game.
Gasell against Payton, and that one's good by Davis.
And those are two teammates right there working in rhythm. One setting the screen and the other using it to get that separation.
Now a timeout called by Miami. Anderson in for Walker. The Celtics also changing it up. Kendrick Perkins, who's checked in for Davis. Garnett comes in for Leon Poe. Rajon Rondo is subbed in for Cassell. Good.
Effective screen set there for the jump shot. That was the key to the play.
Payton against Rondo. Outside Pierce. The Celtics working the ball around now. Garnett dishes to Perkins. The dunk and the foul, a powerhouse move, and he's got a chance for one more at the line. That's on Shaq.
Tell you what, he's not an easy guy to stop when he's got his sight on the rim.
Never has been, never will be. He is a determined finisher.
Did he just go chop-chop there with that one-hand tomahawk slam?
Now here's Wade. He hasn't yet put up any points in this one, and they double up Payton. Back to Wade. Screen by O'Neal. The drive by Wade. Kicks to O'Neal. Fader on the way. No luck. So the Celtics will take it the other way. There's a minute 34 left to play in the first quarter. Garnett with the screen for Rondo. Garnett outside. Back to Rondo. Miami grabs the miss. O'Neal's got four rebounds now tonight. The dish now to Payton. Shaq with the screen, and it's Wade in the corner. Out to Payton, and Anderson has it in the corner. Off the mark here with the three-point shot. So it's Boston now. Allen passes to Rondo. Soft touch off the glass.
And that's what the pump fake's there for. Get your man off his feet and drive right around him.
Mark, they've been looking out of sync offensively.
You know what? A basket here would do a lot for their confidence.
And out of bounds as the Celtics gain possession. There's 37 seconds left in the first quarter. His second make in four attempts.
Huge hole in the defense that possession. He didn't waste any time cutting through it.
29 seconds left to play in the first. Payton kicks to O'Neal. Out to Payton. Passes to O'Neal. To the inside. Six to shoot. Here's Pierce. To Perkins. Here's Rondo. No good trying to beat the buzzer. And that concludes the first quarter of play. It's the Celtics leading by six. And we've got more NBA action on 2K Sports coming your way after this break.
Give it up for your Heat Dancers.
All right, the second quarter beginning in just a moment. And what do you guys think about Boston here in this one?
It's just been a long-range battle for them, and one that they're winning right now.
Yes, sharp shooting from deep, a big part of why they're up.
Celtics leading by six. On the court right now for the Celtics, Rajon Rondo is out there with Allen. And it's Garnett. Then there's Perkins. And it's Pierce in at the three slot. Now here's Allen. Five to shoot. Pierce dishes to Perkins. Here's Rondo. Kept alive by Boston.
You know, one of the basic fundamentals in basketball is the ability to box out. He's got that down pat.
Just a great job of attacking on the break.
Yeah, you know, exploding to the basket like that, Greg, just as soon as that ball was going the other way, that's exactly how you want to do it.
Garnett with the screen for Rondo. The pass to Perkins. Over in the corner, Allen. Back to Perkins. That's tipped. And so he ends a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact, and he'll shoot two.
And you know what? You allow a guy to get right to the rim like that, that's your only option.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, free throws are always better than a layup, so I'd agree with you there, Greg.
And a moment now to quickly take a look at the offensive approach for Boston.
They definitely had a hot hand from three-point range. Always nice to get off to a good start.
Also, what passing we've seen from them here early. I mean, there could be a big number in the assist column if this keeps up.
Good on the second free throw. And we're about a minute into the second quarter of play. Wade outside. And it's out of bounds. The Celtics will take it the other way.
And you know what? His mind's playing tricks on him right now because he's not going to live that one down easily.
Celtics leading by five. Outside Rondo. Down low, Garnett. Good. And it's Rondo who picks up the assist.
They should continue to get the ball inside. The defense struggling to contain them.
And when you make five in a row in close like that, it also takes pressure off your perimeter guys, too.
Now, here's Anderson. Haslam down low, working on Garnett. Haslam can't get it to go.
The inside just a bit too congested for him to get the usual shot he would have with rhythm.
Here's Garnett attacking inside. Kicks it out to Allen. Outside Rondo, six to shoot. He dishes it to Perkins. No good on the shot, a bit long that time.
That's what we call good defense in the paint. Worth its weight in gold.
It absolutely is, and maybe even more than that. I mean, you saw it right there. Without his presence, that's an easy basket.
That one's in there. The Boston lead is cut down now to just five on the bucket from O'Neal. O'Neal's gone 80% from the field, 4 of 5 shooting. Outside Rondo. He kicks it to Perkins. Ray Allen is on the wing. Outside Rondo. Nice ball movement by Boston. No one near him. And he hits the jumper for two. Perkins got the lead up to seven now for Boston. Perkins gotten three of his four shots to fall, hitting 75%. Dishes it to Haslam. Back to Wade. It's a big height bounce and goes in. Wade's got his second basket.
You know, he'll make you scratch your head and throw your hands up as a defender. I mean, you just don't know how to play.
And the whistle blows in the backcourt violation. He went over and back.
Only one turnover so far in the game for him, Kevin. Another reason they're in the lead with halftime approaching, taking care of the ball.
The feed to O'Neal, and Anderson has it in the corner. Took him no time at all on that one. And now just a three-point Celtic lead.
Better to be lucky than good. Got that shot to fall.
Rondo against Payton. Rondo passes to Perkins. And that one is stuffed right through.
Rondo, a master at setting up teammates.
And here are the Heat now. Haslam, a screen on run. And Anderson has it in the corner. Three-pointer, Wade. Good. Wade's got 7 points in the game.
And I like the fact that he really was unfazed by that scoreless first quarter, and now you can see him getting into a rhythm.
Rondo against Payton. It's Pierce on the wing. 5 points in the game. Five on the clock. Allen kicks to Garnett. It's blocked by Shaq. Out of bounds. Celtics ball as Boston keeps possession. And they force the shot clock violation. Great D. Miami trailing. Let's it go with the three. And the Heat, another three.
These defenders had better start closing out on those shooters.
That's two in a row, and we call that a streak.
Outside Rondo. Wade against Pierce. Feeds it to Rondo. And so he draws the foul on the shot. A trip to the line to shoot two. Celtics have shot 2 of 3 from the free throw line tonight. That free throw, no good. Second free throw, good. And here is Payton. He has 7. Shaq with a screen on Pierce. Payton dishes to O'Neal. Clock at 4. Garnett with the block. And they're able to recover.
In a big game for Shaq. He has 9 rebounds and a block. He's gotten after it on the boards for them as well as in the transition game.
And I like the fact that one has really fed into the other.
No luck that time either. Allen against Payton. Left side Pierce. Fires from the line. Here's Perkins. That one is good. He's only missed 1 shot of his 6 taken on the floor.
If you battle for the offensive rebound and come up with it, you're guaranteed a high-quality shot on a follow just like he got there.
Wade passes to Haslam. Kicks it to Anderson. To the left side wing. Here's Payton. And again, it's the Heat missing. The Celtics with the lead. Now here's Rondo. He's got 5. Allen, that's good.
He is on fire from behind the arc.
Yeah, it seems like all of his points are coming from deep, Greg.
Screen by O'Neal. Shaq is screen on Rondo. Wade gets to Shaq. A great 1-2 punch. Beautiful pass and nasty jam.
Went for the two-hander on that slam. That's where the weight room comes into play, Kevin.
I think some urgency from the man.
Yeah, I think he's sensing that this is a critical time in the game, fellas. I think he just sees some things that...
They can't guard us on the perimeter. Spread the floor and isolate up top. Spacing, fellas. Spacing.
I mean, if there's something that he's noticed that can give his team a lift, I think he's got to try to take advantage of that.
So the Celtics call timeout. They're first. Here's Cassell. He's been patient so far. Nothing yet on the scoreboard. Pass to Scalabrine. There's There's a good screen. He feeds it to Poe. Off to a good start as he hits his first shot attempt.
Nice work on the inside. Hard to get that one up and over the big fella.
Well, it's not supposed to be easy down there. And a little artistry on the inside helped him make it happen.
Kevin, he's definitely making his presence felt here in the first half. He's been very effective so far.
Cassell against Payton. Here's Cassell. Can't get it to go. Good D by Payton. Oh, and a fast break for the Heat. And a foul called on the shot. Got him on the way up that time, so he'll shoot two right here. The Heat have shot 3 of 6 at the foul line. He's off on the first.
Taking two shots.
And he's good on the second.
Well, Dwayne Wade in this one, he's got 8 points, and he's also got one block to add to the mix today.
Yeah, and that's just a small part of what we've seen, but it's been a solid contribution defensively.
Cassell against Payton. Cassell, the pass to Allen. Here's Poe. It's hauled in by Dwayne Wade.
I like his tenacity getting to the basket there, even though the dunk rattled out. 99 times out of 100, you'll get the dunk or the foul.
Now here's Payton. He has 7. There's Allen. That's good on the assist by Davis. And the Celtics lead by 4.
And I love the fact that he didn't try to take on the defense by himself. Great pass on the move.
Payton kicks to Shaq. No good. Now Boston takes it the other way. Here's Cassell. Quiet so far offensively, searching for his first points of the game. And it's sunk in by O'Neal. And it's Wade penetrating. And the jam by Udonis Haslam.
Now, this is why the breakaway rim was invented. For plays just like that.
Well, he almost brought the whole thing down, Clark, by hanging on that long.
Yeah, he did.
I tell you what, though, great dunk, and this is even a better game we got going on right now.
You know, they've changed their game here in the second. Getting a little bit more physical, playing with some toughness now.
And I'm looking for them to increase that lead if they can keep getting to the free throw line.
No good on that one. He hits the second from the line. Now Payton. Wade on the wing. The dish to Anderson. Now one against Payton. Shot clock at 5. The Heat need to get a shot off. Haslam. Can't tie it up as that one's no good.
The shooting numbers just aren't there yet in the quarter.
Cassell against Payton. Cassell, the pass to Scalabrine. Here's Cassell. All sorts of time. And Shaquille O'Neal pulls it down. O'Neal's got rebound number 10 tonight with that last one. And finish by Anderson.
Such a strong finisher on the fast break.
And Greg, I love the fact he's always in control. Even though he's going at breakneck speed, he still maintains his body control.
Oh, that was a great angle we just saw, courtesy of Kia. Here's Cassell. The Heat getting the bucket. Nice ball movement by Boston. Here's Scalabrine. Wade is covering. Passes it to Cassell. That's in there. Davis with the assist. And the Celtics lead by 4.
And no matter who it is, that kind of D isn't going to get it done.
Haslam, a screen on Allen. And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Tony Allen. That is his first foul of the game. Haslam, a screen on Allen. Payton outside. On the wing, Dwayne Wade. 5 to shoot. That's in. The Celtic lead is cut down to just 2 points with the bucket from Haslam.
Pretty much all of their buckets coming from inside the paint now.
That's right. Five of their last six makes were on the interior. They've established their inside presence.
Payton against Cassell. And for the ball out of bounds, Davis touched it last. One 10 left in the first half. Haslam a screen. Now one against Payton. And it's Wade in the corner. Pass to Shaq. Six on the shot clock. And unable there to get the go-ahead bucket. Here are the Celtics with the ball. Over in the corner, Allen. 36 seconds left in the second quarter. To the inside. That's good. Davis has got his second bucket.
They have repeatedly probed inside in the first half, guys, and it's paid dividends.
And with as many points as they've gotten in the paint, you know, they haven't had to do much work on the perimeter.
Now, here is O'Neal. He's got 12. Off the left rim and up. Here's Cassell. Scalabrine dishes to Davis. Kicks it out to Allen. And the release was before the buzzer, but it's off target. And we're through the first half of basketball here in what's been a good one. Beginning. Both sides looking to pull away in the last half of the game.
Tremendous output from Allen.
He has 14 points, and he's hit four from beyond the arc. A weapon with those three-point shots.
You said it. His long-range jumpers are having a deadly effect.
Haslam's out there with Dwayne Wade. Then there's Anderson. Then there's Payton. And it's Shaq in at the pivot spot, manning the middle. That's the group on the floor for Miami. It's up a three. Cassell gets the bucket. Cassell's got the lead up to seven now for the Celtics.
They've given up a lot of three-pointers here today.
And their defensive rotations have been non-existent.
And there's the pass to O'Neal. Can't hit. Great D that time from Davis.
Boy, the effort was there, but he just couldn't quite fight his way through traffic.
Dishes it to Scalabrine. He kicks it to Poe. The feed to Scalabrine. It's tipped and stolen by Payton. On up the court. And then Wade slams it in.
Well, they won't be down for long if they can get some more early offense just like that.
And Clark, the best way to get that early offense is with steals that allows you to get out in transition.
Cassell against Payton. And he drops it in from the low post. Cassell's got 9 points. And we're just about a minute and a half into the third quarter of basketball. Feeds to Wade. Shaq with a screen. Wade kicks to Shaq. Here's Haslam. Tried to bank it in, but he misses.
That's not a sight you see very often. I mean, he has a great feel for that jump shot, especially when he's open.
Here's Cassell. And he can't extend the lead to double digits. The Heat trail by 7. Payton kicks to Wade. That's good. And it's Payton with the assist. Payton's got his 5th assist in this one.
I'm not sure that was the play they had set up, but it was too good a look to pass it.
Now here's Allen. Outside, Davis. Poe kicks to Allen. Davis against Haslam. Clock at 4. Shoots from 14. That is good. And that's now 6 points for Davis.
The mid-range jumper is a high percentage shot for him, and when he's got that much room, forget about it.
Wade up top. He's got 13. That's his sixth field goal today, and that makes him now 6 for 11.
Not much the defense can do once he gets to the bucket.
Celtics leading by 4. Right around 3 minutes into the second half. Allen passes to Davis. Here's Poe. Miami grabs the miss. And it's the Heat on the break. Goes up. And then Wade slams it in.
Excellent work there in transition.
Yeah, I think it's always better to go early in transition, to attack when it's there. Because oftentimes you can beat the defense down the floor.
Now here's Allen. Cassell kicks to Poe. He dishes it to Davis. Pass to Scalabrine. Drills it from outside. And the Celtics lead by 5.
Talk about doing a Rip Van Winkle on defense. Come on, guys, wake up. Why are they leaving him open at the three-point line? Come on.
Clark, they've shared the load offensively.
Yeah, they've done a nice job with it, Kevin. Everybody's touching the ball. There's a nice flow to what they're doing offensively.
And, guys, they put the defense on their heels. You can see right now they're trying to react, and that's what you want when you're in a rhythm offensively.
Now the Heat with it. Anderson right side. Haslam a screen. It's Anderson with the drive, and Glenn Davis is going to pick up that foul. That'll be his second foul of the game.
Man, it's close, but, you know, didn't get on balance quick enough.
Yeah, and as quick as players are at this level, in this day and age, I mean, you've got to be perfect in your anticipation to draw the charge.
Right wing. Peyton kicks to Wade. Score of the basket is 8. 8 for 13 from the floor.
Well, they certainly didn't have much of a problem getting the ball into the post that time.
Yeah, and that's important because this game may ultimately come down to which team controls the paint in crunch time.
Here's Poe. So he gets the whistle. Contact on the way up and 2 shots coming up.
Oh, the officials are all over that one.
Clearly a foul. I mean, didn't give him any choice but to blow the whistle. I mean, you got to play without fouling.
And guys, let's get your take on the scoring breakdown so far for the Celtics.
They keep piling up the assists, and they haven't cooled off at all.
Well, it's been a super performance from beyond the arc, too. I mean, they've been reining in those threes.
He hits both from the stripe. The Heat trail by 7. Wade dishes to Peyton. Kicks it to Anderson, and it's out of bounds. The Celtics will take it the other way.
No clue where that pass was going. That is a brutal turnover.
So it's the Celtics now. Here's Cassell. 9 points in the game so far. Down low. It's tipped. It's taken away by Peyton. And now the fast break Anderson with the ball. He feeds it to Wade. Shaq with the screen. Anderson passes to Wade. Heat moving the ball around. Shaq is screen on Cassell. Clock is at 3. Here's Haslam. Offensive rebound. O'Neal. Bricks the dunk off the deceptive pump fake. Cassell kicks to Allen. It's deflected, and it's out of bounds. Last touch by Allen. The Heat trail by 7. Peyton with the ball. 7 points in the game. Anderson outside. Here's O'Neal. Lands soft on the front of the rim and drops. O'Neal's got 14 points for the game.
Some defensive breakdowns are starting to show up now. Their last 4 buckets allowed have come from very close range.
Yeah, high percentage shots are what they are getting in terms of the attempts, and that's just not going to get it done. They have got to figure it out.
Here's Scalabrine. He has five. Misses the layup.
Now that's what we call good defense in the paint. Worth its weight in gold.
It absolutely is, and maybe even more than that. I mean, you saw it right there. Without his presence, that's an easy basket. Solid on the one-hand throw down there.
You know, Clark, when it's a tight ball game like this, he's the guy they want with the ball.
Yep.
Yeah, and one reason why, I just don't know that I've ever seen him miss a play like that.
How's that for an answer? Right back with the dunk.
Boy, he threw out some punishment with that two-hand throwdown.
And Clark, now's the time to do it. Continue to attack that rim.
Anderson outside. The three. Payton's shot is off.
Oh, that's got to be deflating and disappointing to miss a wide-open shot like that right in your wheelhouse.
Poe dishes to Allen. The 10-footer. Miami grabs the miss. O'Neal's got 13 rebounds in the game. Seeding. And Davis gets it to go.
And that's exactly what they're going for on that shot.
Right wing. It's tipped. Shaq passes to Payton. Back to O'Neal. Wade outside. The dish to Payton. Lock at six. Payton can't get that one to fall.
And you know what? He's just not on his game, no doubt about it. Their deficit isn't totally on him, but he has not been an asset for his team. He's obviously hit a bit of a dry spell here, only one of five this quarter.
For Boston, they have gone 6 of 9 at the line.
Call timeout right now just to get his guys to regroup because they were really ragged out there.
Yeah, they've got to get some things straightened out, and sometimes the best way to do that is with the timeout. They look to be overwhelmed right now.
Checked in for Shaq. Morning comes in for Udonis Haslem. Walker's checked in for Anderson. And it's Williams in for Gary Payton. Now here's Wade. 19 points in the game. To the inside. Morning. And he goes strong with the one-handed jam.
D-Wade with an excellent pass there.
Celtics leading by 8. Rondo kicks to Allen. Outside Pierce. Garnett the screen. Outside for Rondo. Ray Allen is on the wing. And Wright pulls it down.
Good pick, but he just couldn't make it count.
Yeah, nice job of setting the screen by his teammate there. And I'm sure he appreciated it.
Now here's Williams. He's been patient so far. Nothing yet on the scoreboard. Down low, Wright dishes to Mourning. And it's Miami with another.
Just no chance for the smaller defender to block that shot.
He's really, really good at using his size to free himself up for those mid-range jumpers. Master that.
Here's Rondo. He has 5. Garnett with the screen for Rondo. Passes it to Garnett. It's good coming on the assist by Rajon Rondo. Garnett's got 5 now.
A lot of space right there to get that shot off.
Not a very good job of the defender getting over the top of that screen in that particular play. The points just keep coming for him this quarter. And just at the right time, too, as they try to narrow the deficit.
Here's Rondo after the made shot from Dwayne Wade. Pierce kicks to Allen. Pass to Rondo. Pulls from the top of the key. Again, the Celtics good for two. The Heat trail by eight. And here's Walker. Right outside. The pass to Williams. Walker dishes to right. To the paint. Here's Pierce. Finish off the break. Pierce has got the lead up to 10 now for the Celtics.
They're straying away from the three-point game here in the second half. And that's fine as long as they're on the lead and they're getting good shots. They've decided not to take nearly as many three-pointers in this half.
Now here's Walker. And here we go with Allen running it up the court. 110 left in the third quarter of the game. Garnett, the screen. And it's Rondo penetrating. For three, Pierce. Basket is good. The assist from Rondo. Rondo's got six assists now in the game.
And really, it looks like he may just try to take this thing over on his own and really build that lead up.
Now here's Williams. He hasn't scored yet. That, I'm sure, will change. Wade passes to Morning. Six on the shot clock. It's good. Now he's shooting 6 for 7.
Just a positive force right now for these guys. And though his team has fallen a bit short, it's not because of him.
And here's Rondo. He's got 7. He kicks it to Davis. Back to Rondo. Right side Davis. Here's Garnett. No good. Walker with some nice D.
That's not the type of opportunity he fails to convert very often.
Wade, good.
And really, the scoring this quarter has been just off the charts, doing all he can to bring them back.
Now here's Rondo. Davis with a screen on Williams. It's Davis with the drop.
He hits the shot at the very last second.
Goodness. Woo! The pressure on him in those circumstances was massive.
Oh, man. What pressure? You guys are over-exaggerating here. I mean, you can't rattle this guy. No matter.
Welcome back. Fourth quarter action starting up in what has been a one-sided show. The Heat trail by 11. And a look at the five for the Celtics to start the fourth quarter. We've got Glenn Davis. Rajon Rondo is out there with Allen. And it's Garnett. And it's Pierce in at the small forward position. Allen kicks to Garnett. Just five to shoot. Dishes to Pierce. Now the feed to Rondo. And a miss there on the triple. Rondo's gone 3 for 8 tonight from the field. And it's Williams. That time the assist by Walker. Williams has got the fourth quarter started here with a bucket for Miami. Rondo kicks to Davis. Ray Allen is on the wing. Wade is covering. Davis sets a screen. Pierce attacking and fouled hard that time. He'll get to the line and shoot two. It's on Alonzo Mourning.
They just haven't been able to contain Paul Pierce. He's got 10 points, and he's hit the mark twice from three-point range as well.
And Clark, it's no stretch to say the more points he gives them from beyond the arc, the better off they'll be.
And the Heat making a change here. O'Neal's checked in.
This is a positive trend for him, especially here in the second half. Shooting just above 80% right now. That's more than respectable. That's good free throw shooting.
Wow, and how huge has he been today? Really just giving his team a nice lift.
Yeah, and he's kept them close enough to be within striking range. I mean, the deficit would be much larger if not for the efficiency of his play.
Garnett with a screen on Williams. Walker against Pierce. Feeds it to Rondo. Davis down low, unloads from 9. O'Neal with the defensive effort.
And that's the way you want to defend. Nice job there.
Always important to have that good interior defense. Cutting into that lead a little bit. Way to finish.
And the basket is still shaking.
Oh, I mean, he has got power in bunches on that two-hand.
Boston leading by four. Pierce with it. He's picked up by Walker. Davis sets a screen. Pierce dishes to Allen. Pass to Garnett. Shot clock at six. Pierce kicks to Rodman. The Celtics working the ball around now. Davis. To the middle. Here's Mourning.
Oh! Now, this is why the breakaway rim was invented. For plays just like that.
Well, he almost brought the whole thing down, Clark, by hanging on that long.
Yeah, he did.
I tell you what, the great dunk, and this is even a better game we got going on right now.
And the highlight reel replay brought to you by Kia. Good stuff on that Kia Slim Jam. Hey guys, what do you think about the offensive approach so far that we've seen for Miami?
Anytime you get as many points in the paint as they have, you know you've got a good thing going and you just want to keep it going.
Yeah, but they've also done a great job of playing in space, getting out in transition every opportunity.
Williams passes to Wade. Outside, Walker. Back to Wade. O'Neal a screen on Allen. Kicks it to Mourning. He dishes it to Wade. Let's go. Oh, trying for it. And out of bounds as the Celtics gain possession. Just over 2.5 minutes played now here in the final quarter of regulation. Over in the corner, Allen. Garnett inside. He's guarded by Mourning. And Davis puts it in.
He is pouring it on in the second half, guys. I mean, a much better showing than he had before the break.
The drive by Wade. Power down. Both hands.
They needed a run desperately, and boy, did they come up big.
And you know, it wasn't just about getting hot offensively. Defensively, they've been stellar as well.
Rondo kicks to Garnett. Back to Rondo. No good. O'Neal with the defensive effort.
Well, you know, they're in the lead, but he's still been frustrated from an offensive standpoint.
From deep three-point range. Celtics leading by three. Outside Rondo. Garnett, the screen. Rondo dishes to Garnett. And it's sent back by O'Neal. And Davis puts it in.
Guys, his consistency in terms of shooting has really helped them seize control.
Wade against Rondo. Wade, double team. Here's Shaq. And Boston with the rebound. Pierce has got his third rebound tonight. Williams against Rondo. For three, Pierce cannot hit. Well, he'd go the other way with it. And Ray Allen gets the whistle that time. That's his first foul. And out of bounds as the Celtics gain possession. The Celtics with the lead. Outside Rondo. He feeds it to Davis. There's the dish to Allen. Back to Davis. Left side Pierce. Just four to shoot. And that one falls coming off of Davis's feed. 13 points for Paul Pierce.
Despite the troubles he had in the first half, he stayed composed and focused, and now he's getting it going.
That one goes. Come on.
I mean, you never expect to get opportunities that easy coming down the stretch of a tight game.
Rondo against Williams. Rondo passes to Pierce. Rondo kicks to Garnett. Outside for Rondo. Pass to Allen. Pulls up. And again, it's Boston converting.
it's as if the defenses have just given up.
Yeah, you know, the pace has only picked up the deeper we've gotten into this game, which is remarkable. It speaks to the endurance and stamina of these teams, and it's also been a lot of fun to watch.
And he just leaves the D in the dust and explodes to the basket.
You're right. Clark, maybe a momentum changer right there, huh?
It could be, Kevin. I mean, a dunk like that can sometimes get an opponent reeling.
Outside Rondo. Davis setting the pick for Rondo. Pass to Davis. Allen outside. Lets the three fly. No luck. Wade with the defensive effort. The Heat trail by five. At the elbow, Williams. Kevin Garnett grabs the miss. Garnett's got his third rebound tonight. Ray Allen is on the wing. He's guarded by Mourning. Pierce kicks to Davis. And it is flushed down with a nice jam.
Taking it to the rack with power right there.
And oh, hammering down with the two-handed slam.
Just piling on the lead with a dunk like that.
You have to like what we're seeing from Ray Allen.
They need to make some adjustments because he's absolutely scorching.
Timeout called, the Heat. Update now from Doris Burke, who's across the way on the sideline.
Hey, guys. Well, Miami's head coach had some advice for the team over that last break. They've been getting torched with all these shots from long range, and he simply said, we can't lose track of their shooters, guys. We're over-helping inside, and it's leaving them wide open. Can they make the adjustment, guys?
Thanks, Doris. Celtics leading by seven. Allen outside. Garnett, the screen. Allen dishes to Garnett. Shoots from eight. Rejected by Walker. And so it looks like the Celtics will retain possession here.
Welcome, fans, to the FIBA qualifying round.
So it's the Celtics now. 13 points was their biggest lead in the game. That falls. Nice feed that time from Dwayne Wade. Wade's got his eighth assist in the game. Now Allen. There's the pass to Garnett. He kicks to Pierce. And there's the defensive 3-second call. And so he hits the technical free throw. Garnett, the pass to Perkins. Stolen by O'Neal. The shot by Payton. And it's in off the backboard.
Wow, he was just wide open there. That's way too easy.
Celtics leading by four. Allen outside. Garnett, the screen. Off the screen. Allen, that's good. Allen's got six in the quarter.
You can't afford to get him that kind of a look.
Well, you know, he came off a good screen, but still, as a defender, you've got to do a better job of fighting over and through that.
Allen against Wade. And there's the feed to Mourning. Puts it up from seven, and the Heat get another bucket right there.
That makes it 10 of their last 12 points coming from inside the painted area.
And really, something that the defense has to address.
Garnett, the screen. Here's Allen. Again, Allen missing. The Heat trail by four. The drive by Wade, and Walker throws it down.
Rising high to throw that one down.
Sky high, fantastic one-hand jam.
Nice way there, guys, to finish up that possession.
Allen kicks to Pierce. And Garnett has it in the corner. And the three off target. That's Miami's ball. Clark, this offense has really been clicking.
No doubt about it, giving the defense all kinds of trouble.
And they know it, guys. They're playing right now with the kind of energy that is hard to deal with.
Dishes to Allen. And stolen by Payton. Walker against Allen. And Mourning throws it down.
And Kevin, maybe the play of the game right there.
A tremendous instinct spray to come up with a steal and then attack the basket.
Game changer right there, guys. An unbelievable play to make it this stage of a really tight ball game.
Again, Garnett missing.
And you know they wanted that one to go down.
They sure did. Would have loved to tie it up right there. Boy, I tell you what, nice little run here that they're going on.
And getting to the 10 has been the key there. Getting point-blank looks time and time again.
Wade brings the double team. Perkins inside. Warnings there. Pocket six. Garnett, the screen. Allen dishes to Garnett. Again, Garnett missing.
The struggles just continue this quarter. They can ill afford to have this many empty possessions.
Stolen by Pierce. And now it's Allen. Running. He can go all the way.
That's a quick bucket there. Solid in transition.
Well, you know, he loves the chance to get out and run. And we can see right there why he does.
Wade against Allen. And it's Wade penetrating. And they will get the basket here, folks, as they rule goaltender.
He didn't get to that one quite in time, Kevin. Those can be tough to gauge sometimes.
Celtics trail by four. Allen outside. And it's Pierce in the corner. Down to five on the shot clock. They double up Pierce. And there's the shot clock violation. Couldn't get the shot off in time.
And as a coach, that's the kind of turnover that drives you nuts.
And, Greg, there's no reason for that turnover to happen. It's just inexcusable.
And he commits the intentional foul. Time called here. The Celtics decide to talk it over. They're trailing by four. 43 seconds left in the fourth quarter.
You've got time. Don't have to isolate immediately.
Changes for Boston. Scalabrini's checked in, and it's Gasellin for Allen. And so here is Miami. Four-point game. Allen against Wade. O'Neal is screen on Allen, and it's Wade penetrating. Morning. Here's O'Neal. Shakes off the strong D and gets the bucket for two. And the Heat lead by six.
Time running low here.
A quick score, Greg, and then probably foul him right away.
1 second separating the shot clock and game clock. Celtics passing it around. Feeds to Allen. Pass to Scalabrine. Pierce gets to Allen. Nails the tray!
And they clearly are just destroying this group right now from the three-point line.
Yeah, and the defense knows it. I mean, they are fully stretched out trying to stop the three-point shot and still haven't been able to do it.
And so the big win by Miami in a tight game. What a show they put out here at home tonight.
Tremendous play.